while I was at the part of my house, what we call the Astro Lounge, discussing the key concepts of astronomy with my friends. I figured that they had a misconception about the color of the sun.
What color is the sun? It's purple. How do you know that? I don't know, I just, yes, it's purple. This is your final answer, yes. Okay, thank you very much. What color is the sun?
I don't think it's yellow, but I'm not sure it's first. Is it white?
What do you think?
What do I think?
What's your final answer?
Okay, white.
What color is the sun?
It should be red, I think.
You think? Why? It's all experience. It's all experience.
Yes.
Years of experience.
Yes.
Is this your final answer?
Yes, this is my final answer.
After doing some research, I understood that this misconception wasn't unique to my friends. It was common among many people.
To tackle this misconception, let's start by looking at a glass prism. As you can see, the white light, or the sunlight, goes in and produces a wide range of colors. To better understand the sunlight, let's get into more detail. This diagram consists of the color spectrum and the sun's blackbody curve, which shows us the intensity of a particular color contained in the light. As you can see, the blackbody curve peaks at green, which is the center of the spectrum. This means that if we assume that this peak point divides the spectrum into two, we can see that the sun emits symmetric intensities of each color as you move right and left from the peak along the curve. To tackle this misconception, let's start by looking at a glass prism. But why do we see the sun in different colors, like red, yellow, and many different tones? Good question. This is a sunrise picture. As you can see, the sun is yellow, and here it's red. During sunrise and sunsets, the light of the sun reaches us at a much lower angle. This means that the light has to travel through a lot more atmosphere space than it used to before. Traveling through greater atmospheric distance means that the sunlight has to travel through much more atmospheric particles than it had to before. As I previously mentioned, sun emits every color of light. The molecules and particles in the air inside the atmosphere scatters away short wavelength colors, colors like violet and blue, and you're left with yellow, orange, and red.
In conclusion, the real color of the sun is actually different than what our eyes can perceive. So the color of the sun depends on who's looking and where that person is looking from. Thank you very much.